Welcome to the Learning from Defects meeting. We want to discuss a particular defect that the team identified, and that's discontinuation of prophylactic antibiotics. So to review this problem, we'll use this Learning from Defects tool and focus on these main questions. What happened? Why did it happen? How are we going to reduce the chance of it occurring again? And how do we know that it reduced the risk? So let's talk about the first question. What happened? In reviewing the events and talking to the team, we have missed discontinuing antibiotics with 20 surgical patients over the last 2 months. So I've selected the latest patient to review, a patient who had a cholecystectomy. He received his prophylactic antibiotics within 1 hour prior to the surgical incision, but the antibiotic was not discontinued within 24 hours post-op. And in fact, the chart says that he got 2 more doses before the mistake was caught and the antibiotics were discontinued. Now, we all know that that's a problem because that could increase the risk for antibiotic-resistant organisms, and we have seen an increase in readmissions for post-op infections. So next is question number 2. Why did it happen?
I remember Mr. Smith. He was the elderly man from Florida with lung cancer who arrived in the unit after a right lobectomy. We went back and checked, and we couldn't find a standing order from the ICU doctor to stop administering the antibiotics. So, unfortunately, the antibiotics were continued, even though they weren't needed.
And we have talked before about the problem of poor communication during handoffs, so even if there was an order to stop, it could have been missed.
We could have an automatic stop order generated from the pharmacy for our post-op patients.
Okay, so we've just named several contributing factors here. Number 1, no standing discharge physician order. Number 2, lack of effective communication at handoff between the ICU and the floor. And number 3, no automatic stop order generated in the pharmacy. So how can we reduce the chances that this will happen again?
We need to flag the steps in the Surgical Care Improvement Project, or the SCIP protocol, in the medical records. So when we hand off care on the floor, or if there's a shift change on the floor, everyone knows when the patient's antibiotic needs to be stopped.
We can write a protocol or standing order and get the surgical committee to approve it so that we have a standing order to stop the antibiotics.
Well, we could have a pharmacist do a double check and monitor the surgical antibiotics to make sure they're stopped, or automatically generate a stop order in the pharmacy.
That sounds good. These are some great ideas. So let's prioritize these. And how well do we think that this specific intervention is going to solve the problem, and how likely is it that the intervention is going to be implemented and executed? So we'll start with putting flags in the internal medical record for the SCIP protocol. So let's have a team discussion and then prioritize this. Thanks very much, team. That was a great discussion. So it looks as if our 3 priority interventions here are to 1, develop a standing order for stopping antibiotics and assign a pharmacist to monitor these. 2, we can generate an automatic stop order in the pharmacy. And 3, we'll need to talk a bit more about improving effective communication at handoff. So, what needs to be done, who's going to be responsible, and when are we coming back together to follow up?
Well, I'll put my name there beside number 1, a standing order for discontinuation of surgical antibiotics. I'll talk to my surgeon colleagues at our next department meeting, and we'll agree to a standing order that you can take to the surgical committee. Our next meeting is next Tuesday, so I'll get back to you by Wednesday.
Okay, and I'll be responsible for identifying a pharmacist to monitor the antibiotics, and I'll work with my pharmacy director to automatically generate the stop order in the pharmacy. I'll need to speak to some of my colleagues as well. I can get back to you by Wednesday too.
Great. Well, we have a staff meeting next week where we can follow up on this conversation. Thanks, everybody.
Thank you.
In our last Learning from Defects meeting, we focused on the issue of stopping prophylactic antibiotics. And I think you'll all remember that we focused on 2 specific interventions to fix this defect. Now, 1 was to have a standing order for stopping the antibiotic, and the 2nd was to assign the pharmacist to monitor these as a double check. Well, I want to thank both Chuck and Erica for taking the lead on these interventions. And I want to encourage all of you to look at our data. There are no misses here. All antibiotics have been stopped appropriately during the past 3 weeks.
That's excellent news. Glad to hear it.